Buenos dias. My name is Pablo. I have this gift of a big family. I welcome you to see this, my family. I will introduce them. Come with me. Welcome to Adelaide. Alma. Well, welcome to our house. Welcome to this family, big family. Thank you to go. Come here. Hola. Hola. Very good. Buenos dias. Well, this is our family. This is my beautiful wife, Alma, and the children that after we will introduce them little by little. Okay, let's go inside. Children, you can help me with some bags. Ole. Venga. Come with us. We arrived in Australia in 2006 as a missionary family. We are from Spain, from Granada, a small city in the south of Spain. Inside of our marriage, our family, at that time, we had just two children, no? Everything was a lot about me, of what can I do, what can... And God allowed, no, for us to pass through a big crisis. And in this crisis, with the help of the church, the help of the community, we found very deeply this love of God. And being open to the life was even to be open to the mission, to be sent whatever, around the world. I mean, well, we offer ourselves to go missionaries, but everything is this out of gratitude. Out of gratitude because the Lord revealed completely our life, revealed completely our family. And in 2005, we went to Italy. It was a meeting of families. Families that they were already missioned, that they were giving their experience, how was these years or months that they were in mission. Very many experiences, very tough, very difficult experiences, but always with this providence of God that was always present. And at the end of this meeting, the families that were still happy to go, we were putting our names in a basket. And then in another basket were the bishops, the places where bishops were asking for families to help in the parishes with evangelization. And well, completely at random, we were chosen to come to Australia. That I remember that was completely out of my plans. Of, I studied geography, Australia, but never in my life thought to come to Australia as a missionary family. We arrived in Australia in 2006 with four children. The youngest one, Tomás, that was 6 months old. And well, little by little, being open to the life, being open to the will of God, God has given us this gift of these 10 children here with us, 8 that are already in heaven. Just to help in the parishes with this catechesis for adults that we bring is to help to bring this adult faith. This faith that many times, even for me, was a faith at the level of the First Holy Communion, but that this teaching, this faith, doesn't give an answer to the problem that we have as adults, a problem that I have with my wife when I was just married. Doesn't give an answer. But the Church has this gift of this catechesis for adults to bring this faith, to grow in faith, and then out of this love, out of this gratitude, we offer ourselves to the mission. And here we are in Australia already 12 years.
Él se preparó, tomó consigo al niño y a su madre y entró en tierra de Israel. Pero al enterarse de que Arcaleo reinaba en Judea en lugar de su padre Herodes, tuvo miedo de ir allí. Así que avisado en sueños se retiró a la región de Galilea. Y así fue a residir en una ciudad llamada Nazaret.
Falling.
my sitting in Granada, in Spain, this catechist, that after the Second Vatican Council and this this reality, this catechesis started to be done in the parishes, my grandparents, they were the first one to listen to this catechesis. They listened to this catechesis, their life changed in such a dramatic way, because even my grandparents being people in the church, but they remember my grandfather was a businessman. And at the end, the priority was first business, after you have the family, God, no? God is everywhere, but first business. My grandparents listened to this catechesis. Their lives changed so much that even my parents, that even through this moment they were struggling a lot in their marriage life, they came to listen to this catechesis in the parish and they start to walk in this small community. When they started, I was 1.5 years old. So let us say that I was brought up inside of the church and inside of this neocatechumenal way, inside of this way of living the faith in a small community, like a family, where really to know each other, to love each other, because you cannot love what you don't know. It's very important this. Since I was in my secondary school, no, I have been always involved with IT. I studied at the university. And coming to Australia, I didn't look for an IT job. And yeah, I was packing apples, delivering junk mail, as a cleaner, so many things, no? How God does things that God doesn't, is not taking anything away from me. Just taking one of my children to the doctors, and this doctor had a problem with the computer. And just like a joke, I told the doctor, well, if you want, I can try to fix it. And he told me, ah, okay, have a go, and I fix it. And this doctor started to call me sometimes. Every time that he had a problem, he was calling me, but something very casual. And just this year, this man put me in contact with an IT company, and I started to work in this IT company, to this IT job, a full-time job that is fantastic in a very big company. That for me has been even to give thanks to the Lord. Well, to find Alma, I found her in the parish. Her parents, they are from the north of Spain. And even in a moment, they offer themselves to be catechists in another place. They were sent to Granada in the south of Spain. And through this, that we came to know each other. I was in one of the communities in the parish when their parents moved to live to my city, is where I met her.
I passed through a big crisis about the meaning of my life. I was very confused about God, about the church. I passed for 3 or 4 years of my life very confused. Didn't know exactly my role in the life, where was God. And I was coming out from this crisis at the moment that I meet him.
And yeah, from the very beginning, I saw that was something special in her, no? I remember when we were going to the Eucharist or to the celebrations, always with the guitar, trying to get closer to, I was looking for her guitar and I was just putting my guitar where she was, and just little by little, they start to know each other.
And we start to go out together. He was in love with me for many years, but I always refuse. But I think because this crisis that I was passing through. And we start to go together. After 4 years, we got married. I was studying chemistry at that time in the university, but I stopped because we really wanted to get married, to start together the life. The thing that I most like of him is that he's very joyful always. He's very positive in the life, always. Let's go. He's not afraid to anything. And this helped me a lot because I am very organized, very, I like to plan the things, everything under control, and he's different.
For many years, I am the second of five brothers and sisters, and I thought that I cannot be loved as I am. That God was saying, you know, I love you as you are. Because for me, Alma was like something completely out of my reach, this love of God, no? And that got manifested in these external things, for example, to meet Alma, to start to go out. After many times that I asked her, do you want that we start dating? And she said, no. Through her love, but even seeing the love of God.
And helped me a lot, no? To trust in the Lord, to, for example, to come to Australia. I follow him and I never regret, no? When we said to come to Panama, to go to Panama, I said, no, no, because we don't have money, it's too difficult. Alma, let's go. He is not scared of the life.
For me, Alma, in so many ways, shows me that the forgiveness of sins is real. It's not only in the sacrament that we go for confession, you confess your sins. With her, that she speaks to me the truth, there is this forgiveness, this possibility to start again. And with Alma, this support is always with the children, of course, no? When we need to, with the children is not only to change nappies or to provide for food. With the children is even with the older ones now, their struggles getting, no, to the teenagers and all of this. And with Alma has been always this support that God acts together. The word that I, in a moment, I don't have, she has this word, this advice, this, but most of all, is this possibility to forgive each other, to start again. In reality, it's not that we didn't plan about to have a big family, a small family. Our background is, for example, my wife is the second of 19 brothers and sisters. She's in a very big family. I am just the second of five brothers and sisters. Inside of of the community, there is a moment that there is very strong this catechesis about the sexuality, the human life. We call this catechesis of the three altars. And for me, to be open to the life was like to be part of this creation of God. Open to what God wants to do. It's not my project, it's God's project. For us to go to World Youth Day, and even we say to the young people, is not a holiday. In the World Youth Day, every day with the young people, there is this constant prayer. We go to the streets with the guitars, with the cross, giving this experience of the gratitude of the love of God to everyone, no? Is this gift. This mission for us to go to World Youth Day is to be this church that is missionary, that goes to the streets, that goes to the people, expecting the people to come to the church. The church that is going to the people, that we show the joy that we have received. Because you program it, because you know, because God exists. And we say to the young people, no, when you go for a trip, for a holidays, you spend a good time, but you come back to your reality, sometimes even with your little depression, no, because you need to come back to reality. From World Youth Day, you go and you come back a different person. For me, it has been paramount to my life. And I like this for my children. And because of this, even that we came to know about World Youth Day Panama on May, this 2008, that they told us, okay, we go. The trip is going to be organized. And when I thought, mama, there is like $25,000. But this was nearly my whole income for last year with my cleaning job. How we will do it, God will provide. Let's go for it. And the reality is, everything has been paid, no? But for me, it's so important. You can say $25,000. We need to change the car. We should do. No, faith. Faith is the most important thing that we can spend this money. And because of this, the graces, even the reality of the life, that life is this pilgrimage. We would like for our lives to be like oiled, I don't know, very stable, very. No, life is always a challenge, it's always, and World Youth Day, these pilgrimages are this reality. In the middle of the struggle, but was in this peace that I know, God, that you are good. Whatever happens, I know that you are good. God is using this situation for His glory.
I remember once, for example, that I was sad because we didn't have food even for the baby. The baby was 6 months and we didn't have any food. And I was telling Pablo, if only I could have some fruit to give to him, it would be enough. 5 minutes later, someone arrived home and told me, look, my daughter came for the weekend. She already left with a baby and she forgot the fruit for the baby. If you want, for me it was a sign, no, that I was asking just the fruit for the baby and someone gave me the fruit for the baby. And many experiences that has been very hard, but always we saw the existence of God, the providence of God.
With the kid, with the schooling and the expenses that are huge, but we have seen again the providence of God. And the last time that we moved house to live here in the south and we were enrolling the children in the schools, for the primary school, speaking with the principal about our situation, that we were missionaries with the Catholic Church, well, but the principal just told us, okay, you pay whatever you can. So don't worry about the school fees, you pay as you can. In all these things, that's it, blessed be God, no? How God is providing in so many different ways. And even our experience is even that the schools, that the children had been going all these years. And we can see that this providence of God is arriving to everyone, not only to us, even to those who are doing this service, no, this gift to us, to the church. I was unable to pay for the rent, to pay for the... After this crisis and to put my trust in the Lord, we came to Australia and I have been for many years just delivering young mail, doing cleaning, builders cleaning, very simple jobs, casual jobs. How we end up eating every day or with the clothes every day, God provides. So many times I say with Alma, I don't know how we are going to pay for this bill, how we are going to pay for the schools, but I know that God will provide. And this is and then after 12 years, this is our experience, this is our joy, no? That really God provides. This is our seventh house here in Australia in 12 years. So the first house after 6 months, they asked us to move. The second house after 6 months, they said, no, you need to move. And in all this struggle, the thing is that we had never been alone because of the parish, the church, the people of the community that have been there always as these angels sent by God as a sign of providence, of love. And always that we face a challenge, there is always this moment of, but then God will provide. One of the biggest difficulties or challenges that we faced was just 4 years ago, that Alma, my wife.
I was for a year with these continually headaches, very strong headaches. At the beginning, we were scared. We went to hospital and they told me, yeah, this is very serious because the tumor is blocking the liquid. So tomorrow, in a few hours, we do the surgery because you are at the point to die.
I remember this day, no? Because, okay, tomorrow morning we cancel everything, we do your surgery, sign these papers, we need to open in the back, maybe she remains paralyzed, maybe she died during the operation.
At that moment, I panicked. I was really scared. I start to question many things, but it is true that there is eternal life. It is true that God exists, that there is something else, or I die and I disappear. What will happen with the children? I don't know. Many questions came and I passed these hours before the surgery in an anguish.
And when everyone left, I was telling Alma, how are you? And Alma was telling me that I am not afraid anymore.
But it's not something that I invent. Really, God gave me the strength. And I went to the surgery and everything was fine.
It's gone, disappear. And I was feeling the same. Whatever happens is for the mission is good. God is good. In the middle of the struggle, but was in this peace that I know God, that you are good. That you provide, that you are our Father, that whatever happens, I know that you are good.
Well, for me, the house is always full of life, full of joy, full of energy. And sometimes even I am tired. I would like sometimes to be alone, to rest, to... But at the end, I realized that I can be 1 hour, but more, I get bored. Where Raquel is the oldest one. She is very intelligent, joyful. But I think the thing that I like most of her is she helps me a lot with the children, with the house, with the cleaning, with the food, everything. She always listens to us, obeys to us, because she recognizes that in obedience is to do the will of God.
My name is Raquel, and I'm the eldest of this family. So I do think my family is a happy family. I mean, we do argue, we do fight, but I think I'm very lucky to have so many siblings, to always have noise in the house, to even be able to argue, to have someone to argue with. I have one friend, and she's the second of two, and she's always calling me to meet up and to do this and that, because in the end, she's alone, and she always tells me, I wish I had as many siblings as you. And I feel maybe this is something that I don't appreciate as much, not the fact that I do have a big family and that this does bring a lot of joy.
And we have Jose, the second one. Always with Jose is this, we say, it has this eyes to see the necessity of the others.
Well, Tomás also is very joyful. He likes to ask questions. He's always asking something. Mom, why this? What does mean this? He's always asking. Yeah, we have the house full of life, no? Full of joy, full of life,
full of noise.
Energy. Anyway, in a big family, you can have one of. They are not all the same, no? Each one has their own necessity.
I am not here in Australia for a better life or to make money. No, no, no. I have already a very good life in Spain and I have a very good job in Spain. I am here in Australia for the mission that we are doing with the church. God is telling me, but I will give you everything. It's not that if you choose to follow me, you will lose. No, you lose nothing. No, you lose nothing. You gain everything.
Shalom World Television is coming to Australia. This is a great gift. It's been gifted to many parts of the world and now it's our Australian turn to receive it with open arms. I welcome it, I bless it. It's going to really support family life, married life, youth, give us a resource that we know that we need really help in these, great help in these areas. May Almighty God bless this new resource coming to our land in the name of the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.